Hello everyone, in the previous video we learned about the aims of chapter 8, that is getting to know plants. Okay, so and today we are going to read this chapter thoroughly. So let's begin. Herbs, shrubs and trees. Our first topic is herbs, shrubs and trees. Next, plants grow all around us. They grow on land as well as in water. It has been estimated that there are about 250,000 types of plants. To make the study of plants easier, they have been divided into groups. The two broad groups are flowering plants and non-flowering plants. Clear? And even these are further divided into many subgroups. So basically, we have divided the plants into two broad categories. These are flowering plants and non-flowering plants. Okay, so it is clear from their names that flowering, that means the plant who has so many flowers onto it, and non-flowering plants, that means the plants that do not bear any flower on it. Got it? So like plants like rose, sunflower and mango are flowering plants. Plants like ferns and mosses do not bear flowers. They are non-flowering plants. Clear? So these are the some examples that a plant has flowers or not flowers. Clear? So flowering and non-flowering. Flowering plants, that means flowers are present on the plant, and non-flowering, that means do not bear flowers. Okay, so another way of classifying plants is according to their size and nature of their stem. Based on this, plants can be classified into three categories. So, and these categories are herbs, shrubs and trees. So students, according to the size of the plants and even their different kind of stems, we have divided them into the three main categories. These are herbs, shrubs and trees. So table 8.1 gives their characteristics and a few examples of each. Can you give more examples? So let's move to our table. So in this table, some parameters are there, and according to these parameters we have divided all these three categories. Okay, so the first one is size of the plant. So first of all, herbs. So what is the size of a herb? It's very small, usually less than 1 meter high. So it is very small in nature. Okay, and even the smallest plant among all these three categories. Okay, and its height rarely just 1 meter high. Okay, and the next we have shrubs. So their size is medium. So these are medium sized plants, and usually their height is 1 to 3 meters high. Got it? So their height is usually 1 to 3 meters high. And the last one we have trees. So these are tall. Clear? So these are the tallest among all these categories, and they generally grow more than 3 meters high. Got it? So it means they just above the height of 3 meters. And next parameter we have nature of stem. So what kind of means stems do these three categories have? The first one is herbs. They are green, tender stem and few branches. That means tender means their stem is very soft in nature. Clear? And the next one we have shrubs. Hard stem but not very thick. Branches arise near the base of the stem. Clear? So their stem is hard but not very thick. Okay. And their branches arise near the base of stem. Clear? From where a stem arises, all these branches arise from the base of it. And next we have trees. Hard, brown, thick stem, branches on the upper part of the stem. So have you ever noticed a tree just below this stem? The trunk is almost bare. It has only bark onto it but not the branches and stems. okay, and these branches just arise above the surface, means above the above part of the tree, okay. And here some examples we have. Herbs examples are grass, tomato, wheat and mint. And in the shrubs, China rose, lemon, rose and pomegranate. Okay, and the third one we have trees. So flame tree, neem, peepal, mango. So these can be the examples of all these three categories. Great, okay. So let's move to our the next previous topic, that is, there is another type of plants that are different from herbs, shrubs and trees. Okay, so we have some more categories that are quite different from these all three. Clear? So these are the plants with weak stems that cannot stand upright. Some of these spread out the ground, for example strawberry, and they are called creepers. Other climb up the help of a support, for example grapevine and gourd. They are called climbers. Clear? So we have another two categories, creepers and climbers. So creepers are the plants that grow or spread out on the ground, okay. And even you can take example of pumpkin, okay, pumpkin, gourd, so sorry, not gourd, pumpkin, and they just spread on the, even watermelon also. So watermelon, even melon and pumpkin, so these are the different examples that you can include in the creepers term. Clear? And next we have climbers. They need some a support to go upright, okay. For example money plant, it's very common plant that you can see in the category of climbers, and it is usually you can see this plant among few people, yeah, around few people, okay. And next topic we have plant system. Okay, so basically plant has two main systems, that is root and shoot system. Clear? So let's begin. Various parts of a plant perform different functions to keep it alive. Let's study the parts of a flowering plant. Okay, so we will take an example of flowering plant, because here we need to explain about the both the parts, both the system, that are shoot and root system. So activity first one is experimental investigation. So we will find out the different parts of the plant. So first of all, dig out a small plant, say a mustard plant, or and examine it carefully. What do you observe? So here they are means saying us to pluck a small plant, that is mustard, and you just first of all you just take out it, and you will notice that the plant has two parts. Okay, so plant has two parts. So let's see what are these two parts. So the underground part of the plant, or the part that remains in the soil, is called root system. It consists of a main root and the number of branching roots. Got it? So the part that is under the ground, it is known as root system. Clear? And it contains a main root and some branching roots around this, around the main root. Clear? So next one we have, the green part that grows above the ground is called the shoot system. It consists of the stem, leaves, buds, flowers and fruits. Clear? So these are the two main parts of this plant that performs different functions, and root system and shoot system. So these are the main systems of the plant. Clear? So root system mainly consists of a main root with the branching roots, and shoot system, it consists of stem, leaves, buds, flowers and fruits. So the part that is below the ground, that is known as root system, and the part that is above the ground level, it is known as shoot system. Clear? So this is what we needed to do in today's video, and in the next video we will go with the next topic, that is the root. Okay, and till that you need to practice or to know about the flowering plants, non-flowering plants, and the difference between herbs, shrubs and trees, and even the difference between climbers and creepers. So this is all you need to practice.